Hi and welcome to my third video about cycles, and today we're going to be looking at answering exam questions to do with the nitrogen cycle. So in the last two videos we looked at how the nitrogen cycle was ordered and the different places that you could find nitrogen found within living things, and then how that can get converted into different types of nitrogen containing compounds. What we're going to look at today is a typical question that you might get asked on an examination paper, specifically an A-level paper. So this question is taken from AQA, and this is the Unit 4 exam, and this is taken from June 2011. This paper is available online. So it's question 8A. Much of Indonesia is covered with forest. Large areas of the forest have been cleared and planted with palm oil trees to be used in the production of fuel. So 8A, in these forests, nitrogen in dead leaves is made available to growing plants by the action of bacteria. Describe the role of bacteria making the nitrogen in the dead leaves available to growing plants. And so this question is worth 5 marks, so quite a big mark question. And therefore you'd be given usually a side of A4, at least 3/4 of a side of A4 to write your answer. Now if we go back to the nitrogen cycle and look, what you first of all, I think the best thing to do is to establish what it's asking you to go from and then where that's asking you to finish up. So if we look at our nitrogen cycle, the question is asking bacteria making the nitrogen in dead leaves available to growing plants. Okay, so what you have is nitrogen containing molecules found in producers, so plants here. And you're looking from going from this point, so from the death of the plant, through to here, down to the decomposers, and then you're looking to make it available to growing plants. Now the only place that it's going into the plant is up here. So essentially what you're doing is you're going from this section of the diagram, round to here, up through here, and along to these points, and then made available to the plant. So that's up to nitrate ions. So that's the first point at which those can be absorbed by a plant and therefore used. So the question's asking how we get from basically here, the death of the plants, through to nitrate ions. And so, if you look at it logically, basically we're going to take a path all the way through this diagram. So, the first part is the organism dies, and then that's broken down by decomposers. But there's a specific term that you need to use in order to score the mark here. And that is saprobiotic or saprobionts or saprophytes. That's just identifying the type of bacteria that break down dead material. From there, they use or they digest and break down proteins, DNA, nitrogen-containing substances found within the dead plant. So you have to talk about the digestion or the breaking down of the dead material. And you need to be specific in talking about proteins or DNA or nitrogen containing substances. You need to say something that contained actually nitrogen. From there, what you need to discuss is you need to talk about extracellular digestion or the release of enzymes from these bacteria. You could then maybe go on to talk about actually digestion itself, the breaking down of the proteins or the DNA found within the dead material, but in this instance that doesn't score any marks. From here, you then reach this point. So we've got to the organism's been broken down. You then have this process, ammonification, and that produces ammonium ions, and that's the fourth mark available here. And so the fourth mark is referring to ammonia or ammonium ions being produced. From there it's quite straightforward because we're going from ammonium ions and we're going to produce nitrite and nitrate ions. So mentioning ammonia being converted into nitrate to nitrate or ammonia to nitrate, you don't even need to mention the intermediate nitrite. You can just go straight from ammonia to nitrate is the next mark. And if you wrote down all of the things up to this point, you'd gain the 5 marks. From there, you could talk about these things being nitrifying bacteria or the fact that the process is called nitrification. Those two are given for the same mark. And then the seventh mark is knowing that it's an oxidation reaction. So essentially any of the 5 points that you say here, if you mention any 5 of those, assuming that the rest of the information that you put down is accurate, you'll gain the full 5 marks. But essentially what you're doing is you're taking, or you're looking at, where the question is asking you to go from and to. You'll notice as well the question is very specific, making it available To growing plants. What it does not say is it doesn't want you to talk about absorption via active transport or how it's absorbed into the plants, just made available. So it's asking for the version of the nitrate containing compound that the plant can absorb, and in this case that's nitrate.